Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here. Skincare nerd, chemistry PhD, and big fan of guacamole with extra lemon juice. Lemon is awesome in food. But today I'm going to be talking about the science of why lemon belongs in your body and not on your body. If you like this sort of video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell to make sure you don't miss any of my videos. If you've ever been on Pinterest, you'll know that there's tons and tons of DIY skincare recipes. A lot of them use common kitchen ingredients, and one of the most popular ones is lemon juice. You'll find it in tons of hair and skin recipes. These recipes claim that lemon juice does tons and tons of different things. It'll brighten skin, it'll lighten pigmentation, it'll clear up your breakouts, it'll reduce oil production, exfoliate your skin, and reduce wrinkles. It'll get rid of blackheads, it'll reduce your debt, it'll solve global warming. Lemon is cheap, and it smells really nice. But is it effective? And more importantly, is it safe? Let's talk about the science behind lemon juice. Let's start by talking about the chemicals inside lemon juice. There is a bit of truth about all of these amazing claims about what lemon juice can do. Lemon juice does contain a lot of ingredients that are used in skincare, as the Pinterest DIY recipes will say. Lemon contains vitamin C in the form of ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid is a fantastic ingredient for evening out pigmentation. Ascorbic acid is an antioxidant which prevents free radical damage, and so it can help with sun damage, also known as photoaging, and wrinkles. Ascorbic acid can also potentially increase the collagen in your skin, which will make it plumper and less prone to wrinkling. There's also citric acid, which is an alpha hydroxy acid, or AHA. Alpha hydroxy acids will exfoliate your skin. I've talked about them before in my video on exfoliation. There's also a free exfoliation guide that I've put together that you can download if you want to find out more about exfoliation. Chemical exfoliants like alpha hydroxy acids can help with acne and aging. They can give you plumper, smoother, brighter skin. Another one of the components of lemon juice is niacin, which is a form of vitamin B3. You might know it better in the form of niacinamide. It's an anti-inflammatory that helps with pigmentation, and it helps with dry skin as well. So theoretically, lemon juice could be great for your skin. But of course, there's a catch. So don't rub a lemon on your face yet. An important question we have to ask is, what is the strength of each of these ingredients in the lemon juice? One of the problems with natural ingredients is that there's lots of variation about what chemicals are actually in there. The exact components will vary with things like season, location, so where it's grown, how fresh the extract is, how ripe it was when it was harvested, how it's been stored, whether it's been refrigerated or not, whether it's been left in the sun. I've talked about some of these issues in my video on natural skincare, but let's have a look at what's in a typical lemon. It's got somewhere around 44.5 milligrams of ascorbic acid per 100 mils of lemon juice. This translates to 0.04%. There's about 5% citric acid, and there's 0.0001% niacin. If we compare these percentages to what's in a formulated skincare product, normally you'll see ascorbic acid in vitamin C serums at about 5 to 20%. Alpha hydroxy acids will be 2 to 15%, and niacinamide will be 2 to 10%. So you can see that the dose of these ingredients in our lemon juice is pretty low compared to in a properly formulated skincare product, apart from the citric acid. What this means is that you're not really getting enough of these ingredients on your skin through lemon juice to make a big difference. It's not going to be a great substitute for a regular skincare product. So in terms of effectiveness, lemon juice is probably not that great. We also need to talk about safety. Lemons contain millions of other chemicals apart from these ones that we know are good in skincare. That's because most things in nature are complex mixtures. They haven't been purified yet. One of the biggest issues about lemon juice is that it contains phototoxic chemicals. These are called sirolins, which are a subset of furanocoumarins, or furocoumarins. These chemicals are found in many citrus peels, including lemon and lime. If you're squeezing a lemon at home, you can't really separate the juice from these phototoxic components. These furanocoumarins are also found in parsnips, celery, parsley, and figs. The problem is that when they're on your skin, they react with UV to cause something called phytophotodermatitis. In other words, a skin reaction caused by plants when it interacts with sunlight. The symptoms are red skin and horrific blistering that develops over the next 48 hours after light exposure. There's going to be some really gross blisters coming up, so look away now if you're squeamish. It's over, the blisters are gone. Oh, it's okay. It's okay. It's not entirely clear what the exact mechanism of how these chemicals cause this massive blistering on your skin. Either they react with DNA to form crosslinks, or they interact with proteins in your skin, which cause your keratinocytes, or skin cells, to die and your membranes start rupturing. The overall process leads to damaged cell membranes, which results in cell death, edema, which is swelling, blistering, and injury to your skin. After this reaction, you might get post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which is pigmentation after damage, and this can take months to heal. In proper skincare products, a lot of the time, the citrus essential oils have been processed to remove these phototoxic chemicals. But this doesn't happen if you DIY. Another scary possible side effect is something called chemical leucoderma. This is when your skin gets depigmented. In other words, you get uneven areas of faded pigment. There's been a few reports in the literature of this chemical leucoderma. For example, one woman used a lemon toner for 3 months on her face. And so you can see the areas where there's been hypopigmentation, in other words, less pigment than there should be. In another instance, someone rubbed a lemon on their face for 5 days. Their skin became really irritated, it scaled up, the skin exfoliated, and then they got lesions. These lesions healed after about 5 days, but it left depigmented patches. This doesn't seem to be an allergic reaction, it's some sort of toxic reaction. And it could be partly because lemon juice has quite a low pH. In other words, it's very acidic. It has a pH of about 2. So we assumed at the start that lemon juice was cheap, but is it really? In Australia, citric acid is $2.25 for 75 grams, whereas lemons are currently $1.78 each. Each lemon contains 30 to 45 mils of juice, 5% converts to 1.5 to 2.25 grams of citric acid, so 75 grams would be $60 to $89. It's actually way cheaper to go out and buy citric acid and dissolve it in water than to use lemon juice. Plus, you avoid the phototoxicity. I still probably wouldn't recommend it because the pH would still be quite low. So even if you avoided the light-induced blisters, you could still get the hypopigmentation. And citric acid is quite large, so it will work better in a properly formulated product designed for skin. If we compare lemon juice with properly formulated products, it isn't that cheap either. Since citric acid isn't that popular in exfoliants, I'm comparing it against other alpha hydroxy acids like glycolic and lactic acid, and I've converted them so we're comparing the same number of molecules of each type of AHA. As you can see, there are some products that are quite comparable in price, plus there's even a couple that are cheaper. These products have a lot of added benefits, for example, a lot of them have antioxidants, plus they're in a base that will help the alpha hydroxy acids penetrate and work. Now there's the concept that the dose makes the poison, so lemon juice might not always be unsafe. But I wouldn't recommend using it in leave-on recipes with large amounts of lemon juice. In wash-off recipes or recipes with really small amounts of lemon juice, it might be fine. It's still a lot safer to use a product that's been specifically formulated to go on your skin. If you're still determined to use lemon juice, then I highly recommend that you only use wash-off recipes with really small amounts of lemon juice, and to immediately stop if you get irritation or if you see any pigment changes. You should also wash it off really thoroughly before you go out into the sun and use sunscreen. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for tons more beauty science. See you next time!